Good morning. Welcome to Capital Breakfast. Today is a very big day. We're joined by someone who's actually co-hosted this show with me before. I am talking about Lady Miss Camila Cabello. Yeah.
You just got some people so excited for you to say Lady Gaga.
Lady Cabello.
Lady Camila Cabello.
Hey, well, listen, Camila, thank you so much for coming in today.
Well, thank you so much for having me. Remember when I co-hosted?
I know.
Thanks for doing that, by the way.
I know. It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. But you're here today. You're back in the UK. Are you staying for a little bit longer this time?
Literally 20 hours left in my trip.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I know.
20 hours left.
I know.
Okay,
I can't get enough of you guys.
You are tweeting a lot about the Nando's Black Card.
I know. When will they give it to me?
Have they tweeted you back yet?
I don't know. Can somebody check for me? Because that would be, I would just be getting rejected just shamelessly by Nando's if that's the case. No, they've definitely tweeted me back before, but I think they're just kind of like, you know, they're just kind of like ghosting me on this black card thing a bit.
Well, we were saying earlier on in the show about the best chip, like the best fry, I'd say for you, ever.
The best fry at Nando's?
Yeah. No, in general.
No,
so, like, what would be
cards.
The best one ever? Some people say, like, McDonald's chips and all that
I
type
would
of stuff.
Say McDonald's 100%.
Yeah.
That's a big one. It's a big one. Yeah. Just kidding. Nando's is really good, though, because they have the little... I actually bought the powder, the little red powder.
Yeah.
I bought peri-peri salt.
I bought the peri-peri salt.
And why have they not given you a card yet?
Can I just say, if you want to get that black card, you can't be coming on here and saying that theirs is not the best chip.
I know. Yeah, what I was about to say was that with the peri-peri salt and with the sauce, yeah. I would say Nando's is tied with McDonald's
fantastic.
Fries. And I trust them more.
South of the border. We're absolutely loving it.
Oh,
obviously,
thank you.
The track with Ed. What was it like working with him?
It was so fun. I mean, I've been such a big Ed Sheeran fan for such a long time. So it was like... I remember just being so nervous and so excited to go into the studio with him, even though we've been friends for a while, but yep. I was just like, you know, it's like, think of like the person that you've just, like, I have named him in every interview since I was like 15. So it was like, you know, it was a big deal for me. It was like one of those moments.
Wow. That is so good.
I saw there was a video he posted on Instagram, and he censored his mouth.
I know.
He was saying something.
I don't know what he said.
You must know what he said.
I swear to God, I don't.
Camila, I actually looked at
the video 5 times in a row trying to figure it out, and I should probably just email him and ask him.
Look at me. What did he say?
He said, Nando's will never give you the black card.
He's got a great relationship with Nando's, so sticking with him.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
He does. He really does. We've got to talk about Senorita.
Yeah.
So big. It was number one for such a long time. Obviously, massive track with Shawn Mendes.
Yeah.
What was it like working together? Why did you work together on that?
Well, it was so fun. You know, we've been friends for a really long time. And, you know, we were kind of like, we just didn't, there was like a period where we didn't hang out as much just because we were both busy. And this song was really fun because we got to just hang out again, like we did on the song we did before. I know what you did last summer, which is when we got really close. This was just like, you know, we were like, oh, yay.
Yeah.
We get to, you know, be pals and just hang out.
It is really cool. But I have to say, it was a nice moment for me because I remember having you both on FaceTime here.
I remember that. Was that for I Know You Did Last Summer?
Yeah.
That is so funny. Yeah. I actually remember that.
And, you know, both of you, you're so lovely. And seeing all of this, it is so... It's good, mate. With you and Shawn as well. I mean, you guys just look so happy at the moment. Is that the case?
Yeah, we're pretty happy. I really, really love him a lot.
Look at that video.
We have a game right now. On the line, I've got two callers, each with a story. One of the stories is real. One of them is a lie. So one person is a liar. It is up to you, Camila, to work out who is telling the truth and who's telling the lie.
I think I can do this.
Okay. You get to ask a couple of questions to each of the callers, and then you listening as well are going to have to figure out and help out Camila with who is telling the truth.
Okay,
so on line one, I've got Jesse. Jesse, good morning.
Hi, morning.
Good morning, Jesse.
Good morning, Jesse.
What's the top line of your story? Go on.
Okay, so I once ate a tissue belonging to Beyonce.
You once ate a tissue belonging to Beyonce.
It wasn't used.
A piece of her lives inside me now.
Wow.
Was the tissue used?
I think it was. It was a little bit damp, not going to lie.
Oh. Dave, what's your story?
I once lost Prince Harry and William and forgot who the Queen was.
Is there any questions you want to ask for that one?
Wait, I don't get it. He lost...
He was looking after the royal family.
Oh, okay. Yeah, thank so you. Literally, my brain did not understand.
Because I didn't understand that.
I did not understand that. I literally was like, I don't know what question I'm going to ask him besides, I don't understand what you're talking
about. Oh, so David.
So you were looking after the royal family. What were you wearing when you were looking after the royal family specifically? And you can't take any pauses. You got to say it now.
Army clothes.
Just straight up army clothes.
That was quite fast. I just don't believe that you forgot who the... Did he say forgot who the queen was?
Yeah. Yes.
I don't believe that because you're a UKer. I've made my decision.
You've made your decision.
You've done your detective work.
Okay.
The first girl is telling the truth.
So you think Dave is the liar?
I think Dave, yes.
Camila Cabello, I can reveal you are... Incorrect.
What?
Yeah. Dave, I was so confident.
Dave
is telling the truth. Dave, aren't you?
So basically, Harry and William had gone a wee bit of a wander and they were a lot younger. They weren't teenagers. Long story short, they basically fell asleep in a barn and we got sent out to try and find them. We couldn't find them. And then when we got back, we got told by Prince Charles that in the evening, we were helping out serving food to the royal family and the guests. But we sit in the kitchen in the background. So the Queen entertains the guests. And then during that time, we had a little bit of a drink or two. And then when it came to the point of serving the food, we got a little bit confused because we were then a little bit tipsy and we couldn't remember who the Queen was. So when it came to the time of actually serving the Queen, the guy who walked out looked at us and said, I can't remember who the Queen is. And then we're like, there's a big table. That person right up there walks out, goes to serve and gives the food to a completely different lady. And the Queen's just sitting there looking at him like,
oh my God.
Okay.
Wow.
That's a good story.
It was funny for us, but it's not like we were out shopping with the royal family and we lost the kids or anything like that, you know?
Dave, that story deserves a round of applause.
Yeah. And thank you
so much.
That's how he lost his job.
Yeah, that's how Dave lost his job.